has been replaced by two forms, that is 34A and 34B. The former now is headed Presidential Election Results at Polling Station, and the latter Collation of Presidential Election Results at the Constituency Tallying Center. Form 34C is the one to be used in place of 37 for the final declaration of result of election of president at the National Tallying Center. The new regulation 87 specifies that upon receipt of Form 34A from the constituency, returning officers, the chairperson of the appellant shall, in quote, verify the results against Form 34A and 34B received from the constituency returning officer at the National Tallying Center, end quote. The controversial Regulation 83.2 and 87.2 were not affected by the amendments, and the object is not difficult to see. The High Court, having found those regulations to be inconsistent with the Constitution, it was in bad faith for the appellant to reenact them while pursuing this appeal. It is our firm position that the purpose for which Section 39, 2 and 3 of the Act and Regulation 83.2 and 87.2C were promulgated or made have the effect of infringing constitutional principles of transparency, impartiality, neutrality, efficiency, accuracy, and accountability. To suggest that there is some law that empowers the chairperson of the appellant as an individual to alone correct, vary, confirm, alter, modify, or adjust the results electronically transmitted to the National Tallying Center from the constituency tallying centers is to donate an illegitimate power. Such a suggestion would introduce opaqueness and arbitrariness to the electoral process, the very mischief the Constitution seeks to remedy. We reiterate the words of the learned judges of the Supreme Court in George Mike Wanjohi that we have cited earlier, and this is what the judges said in relation to what we've just said. Quote, apart from the priority attaching to the political and constitutional scheme for the election of representatives of governance agencies, the weight of the people's franchise interest is far too substantial to permit one official or a couple of them, including the returning officer, unilaterally to undo the voter's verdict without having the matter resolved according to law by the judicial organ of state. It is manifest to this court that an error regarding the elector's final choice, if indeed there is one, raises vital issues of justice such as can only be resolved before the courts of law. Accuracy of the count is fundamental in any election. Voter turnout determines the outcome of any electoral contest. Numbers are therefore not only unimpeachable, but they are everything in an election. The lowest voting unit and the first level of declaration of presidential election results is the polling station. The declaration form containing those results is a primary document, and all other forms subsequent to it are only tallies of the original and final results recorded at the polling station. We we reiterate, as we conclude, that there is no doubt from the architecture of the laws we have considered that the people of Kenya did not intend to vest or concentrate such sweeping and boundless powers in one individual, the chairperson of the appellant. The responsibility of the appellant to deliver a credible and acceptable election in accordance with the Constitution is so grave and so awesome that much approach and must approach and execute it with absolute fidelity, probity, and integrity. The appellant must, in all his dealings, be truly above suspicion and command respect of the people of Kenya for whom it acts. Much depends on it. Indeed, the present and future peace of this country. Ultimately, we find no fault in the determination of the High Court to the extent that Section 32, 39, 2, and 3 of the Act and Regulation 87, 2, C provide that the results declared by the returning officer are provisional, and to the extent that Regulation 83.2 provides that the results of the returning officers are subject to confirmation by the Commission, these provisions are inconsistent with the Constitution and therefore null and void. There is no merit in this appeal, which we accordingly dismiss. Because of the public interest nature of this appeal, we make no orders as to course. Mr. Paul Mwangi, we now have our quorum sheets. We need to have our record straight of those who are before us. Who appears with Mr. Ambua Kilonzo. Well, for the first, second, and third respondent, we have Mr. Willis Otieno, Mr. Ochieng Odinga, for the Attorney General, the fourth respondent. We have Mr. Charles Mutinda and Mr. Stephen Dede. Matter of correction, Mr. Ben Sihanya appears with Mr. Willis for the first, second, and third. I was placing him with the sixth respondent, I'm sorry. Yes, it is my, he came in as the proceedings were going on, my lord, for the sixth respondent, I appear together with Mr. Otende Amolo, Ms. Judy Olo, Mr. Antonio Watch, and Ms. Celestine. And Mr. Andrew Buchemi, also for the photo. Buchemi. For the fifth respondent, this Mr. Lempa Sonyenka. So there's a Mr. Orenja Omina.
meager. That is the first, second, third respondent.
Is that it?
That is it, my lord. My lord, on behalf of all the advocates appearing today, we express our gratitude for your ruling today. Unless any party has any application.
My lord, I just wish to repeat what my senior colleague has, the gratitude which he has expressed on behalf of all of us to the court. My lord, we have three brief requests to make to your lordships. If it is possible, my lord, for the court to supply during the course of the day a copy of the judgment.
On behalf of this bench, we also would like to thank our counsel who participated in this appeal regarding the application of the copy of this judgment and the decree. Yes, the judgment will be available at the end of the day, a few corrections, but at the end of business today, you should be able to get a copy, and thereafter, the usual exchange of the decree and all that can take place. We thank you, and the court now.